Olympian Kyle Chalmers is having a cracking start to the Swimming World Cup. He smashed the Australian record for 50-metre butterfly and he's currently in Russia preparing for the next leg of the tournament. It's late there, but he joins us now and he's going to share some hair-raising news. Kyle, a pleasure to speak to you. Thanks for staying up for us tonight. I know it's getting late there for swimmers.
It is getting late here for swimmers. It's just ticked over the 10:30 mark, which is normally an hour past what I'd normally go to bed. So
she's
a late one for me, but I'm lucky I'm on my own training schedule here, so I will just make sure I have a bit more of a sleep in the morning.
Yeah, there you go. Good on you. Thank you for that. Before we chat about this new partnership of yours, congratulations on the swims in Doha.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, pretty it was good. Aussie record in the 100 freestyle, third fastest all time and very, very close to the world record. And then the 50 butterfly was a bit of a surprise. Started out as a butterfly. I haven't done any butterfly probably in the last 7 to 8 years. Decided that I'd have a crack at it on day 3 of the competition and ended up breaking the Australian record in the 50 butterfly. So very happy with those two results. Start racing again here in Kazan on Thursday. Race Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then the World Cup series is over. So on to ISL in the Netherlands for 6 weeks. But it's been a lot of racing, but it's been good fun.
That's awesome. Yeah, you must be buzzing for that upcoming meet, all right. And congratulations on the Olympics this year as well. I mean, you narrowly missed out on the gold, but it was just 6 months after your shoulder surgery. It's some effort. And how's the shoulder?
Shoulder's okay. It's slowly getting better. It's something I think I'm going to have to deal with and manage for quite some time, obviously, the Olympics. It was a quick turnaround from shoulder surgery to get back there, but I ticked everything I possibly could off and I am really happy with the result, obviously. It is hard, only 0.06 of a second, and I would have been a back-to-back Olympic gold medalist, but I put my best performance in the pool. I did everything I possibly could, and I'm so proud of myself and so happy with that silver medal, and it means so much to me, honestly, in my collection of medals I've got. That one now would be probably my number one because I know how much I've had to sacrifice and work for over this last 5-year period in between Rio and the Olympic Games in Tokyo. I've had heart surgery 2 or 3 times. Wow. I've had shoulder surgery. I've had 12 cortisones in my left shoulder, 3 in my right. I've had cortisone in my ankles. I've had 3 facet epidurals in my back. And that's just the injury side of thing, obviously. There's a whole lot more to life than injuries. You have your family problems that go on. You have everything. So to get through that 5-year period and stand back up there in the Olympic final and swim a personal best time, I really can't complain. So I'm happy and proud, and it's motivated me to continue on in the sport and take that gold medal back in Paris. That's mine. So I want to make it a gold medal sandwich.
There you go. I absolutely love that. You know, that's the part that we don't see, the part that we don't see you training. We just see you at the tournament. And in terms of competition, for sure, there's no more motivation than a silver medal. But we absolutely love you. How's your jump shot? Because you're a big basketball fan as well, huh?
Yeah, I'm pretty lethal from the 3-point line. So yeah, might get the call up for the NBL, just waiting. I've got my phone on loud most days. Obviously, the season's about to kick off. So if they need an aquatics athlete who can drop the odd 3-point off the bench, I'm ready to suit up. So, feel free to reach out.
That's it. We always need to be thinking after these gold medals, of course. It's great speaking to you. You have so much character, and that's what we need from our sports stars as well. You've proved you've got a good sense of humour with this new commercial you made as well. We're going to take a look at it here.
Righto, Kyle. I'm feeling the gold. Quick check. Goggles, cap, will to win. Are you pumped, son?
All good, Kerry. I'm ready.
Kyle! Silver! You swam your PB and there was only a hair in it. You used your wall stainless steel trimmer to trim down, right? It's okay, mate. We'll get them next time.
That's awesome. And there was only a hair in it. Did it take some months before you were able to laugh about missing out on that gold?
It did. I think especially that advert, shooting that advert, it kind of almost rubbed a bit of salt into the wounds, to be honest with you. But it was fun. I actually really enjoyed doing the commercial shoot with him, Dave Eastgate. He's a comedian, so it made the day go very quickly. And I think the final product's funny, and how I kind of want to be portrayed as well. I think it's a different level of me. You always see these serious sides of things, but here I am trying to almost, you know, take the piss out of my Olympic race, and that if I'd shaved down, I would have got that gold medal. So I think it's an exciting campaign to be a part of, and obviously shaving down is the important, most important part of my pre-race ritual. So tomorrow before I race, I'll spend 2 hours shaving my body from head to toe. So having the best available products makes my job a whole lot easier on those days as well.
Fantastic. I love it. And along with Wal, you're looking for Australia's craziest beard as well. What are you looking for and how can people enter?
Yeah, so they can enter at wahl.com.au, so W-A-H-L. And, yeah, I'm going to be the sole judge of the competition. So I know in sport, even in the athletic field, people seem to be running some pretty awful facial hairs at different points of their careers. And I know that a lot of people obviously being locked down doing their own home jobs. I'm sure there's some terrible ones floating around. So I'm looking forward to what gets sent through. The winner receives $2,500 worth of products. So I think there's quite a big incentive right there just to send a photo through. I wouldn't mind seeing some coloured beards, like people maybe taking their browner beards back into a white, like a bleach, and then maybe adding some greens and blues throughout it. I think there could be some really fantastic things done. It's just who wants to go the hardest to win the prize.
There you go. You've been told how to win from the horse's mouth themselves. I'm just picturing you as being the hairiest man in Australia outside of comp.
Yeah, I get very, well, hairy on the face. To be honest, I spend so much time in the chlorine that it pretty much just kills all the hair follicles on my body. So it's not something that I have to worry about all that much. But for some reason, the facial hair still grows on pretty strong. I shaved all this off about 2 days ago and I've started to get the afternoon shadow again. So tomorrow it comes off and it hopefully stays off for the 3 days of competition, but might have to give it a bit of a touch up midway through.
That's it. Good on you. Kyle, thanks so much for joining us today. Good luck for the upcoming swims. You're a legend. Australia loves you.
Hey, no problems. Thanks for having me. Good to see an Australian face, hear some Australian voices, and miss you all at home for sure. Thanks for the support.
Good man, Kyle. We'll be following you.